unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord God of Israel against the pastors that feed my people. You have scattered my flock and driven them away and have not visited them. Behold, I will visit upon you the evil of your doing, says the Lord. And I will gather the remnant of my flock out of all countries, whether I have driven them, and will bring them again to their folds, and they shall be fruitful and increase. And I will set up shepherds over them, which shall feed them, and they shall fear no more, nor be dismayed, neither shall they be lacking, says the Lord. Behold, the days come, says the Lord, that I will raise unto David a righteous branch, and a king shall reign and prosper, and shall execute judgment and justice in the earth. In his days Judah shall be saved, and Israel shall dwell safely. And this is his name whereby he shall be called, the Lord our righteousness. Therefore, behold, the days come, says the Lord, that they shall no more say, the Lord liveth, which brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt. But the Lord liveth, which brought up and which led the seed of the house of Israel out of the north country, and from all countries whither I had driven them, and they shall dwell in their own land. Mine heart within me is broken because of the prophets. All my bones shake. I am like a drunken man, and like a man whom wine has overcome, because of the Lord and because of the words of his holiness. For the land is full of adulterers. For because of swearing, the land mourneth. The pleasant places of the wilderness are dried up, and their course is evil, and their force is not right. For both prophet and priest are profane. Yea, in my house have I found their wickedness, says the Lord. Wherefore their way shall be unto them as slippery ways in the darkness. They shall be driven on and fall therein. For I will bring evil upon them, even in the year of their visitation, says the Lord. And I have seen folly in the prophets of Samaria. They prophesied in Baal and caused my people Israel to error. I have seen also in the prophets of Jerusalem, in horrible thing. They commit adultery and walk in lies. They strengthen also the hands of evildoers, that none does return from his wickedness. They are all of them unto me as Sodom, and the inhabitants thereof as Gomorrah. Therefore, thus says the Lord of hosts concerning the prophets, behold, I will feed them with wormwood and make them drink the water of gall. For from the prophets of Jerusalem is profaneness gone forth into all the land. Thus says the Lord of hosts, hearken not unto the words of the prophets that prophesy unto you. They make you vain. They speak a vision of their own heart, and not out of the mouth of the Lord. They say still unto them that despise me, the Lord has said, you shall have peace. And they say unto every one that walketh after the imagination of his own heart, no evil shall come upon you. For who has stood in the counsel of the Lord, and has perceived and heard his word? Who has mocked his word and heard it? Behold, a whirlwind of the Lord is gone forth in fury, even a grievous whirlwind. It shall fall grievously upon the head of the wicked. The anger of the Lord shall not return until he have executed, and until he have performed the thoughts of his heart. In the latter days it shall consider, you shall consider it perfectly. I have not sent these prophets, yet they ran. I have not spoken to them, yet they prophesied. But if they had stood in my counsel, and it caused my people to hear my words, then they should have turned them from their evil way, and from the evil of their doings. Am I a God at hand, says the Lord, and not a God afar off? Can any hide himself in secret places that I shall not see him, says the Lord? Do not I fill heaven and earth, says the Lord? I have heard what the prophets said that prophesy lies in my name, saying, I have dreamed, I have dreamed. How long shall this be in the heart of the prophets that prophesy lies? Yea, they are prophets of the deceit of their own heart, which think to cause my people to forget my name by their dreams, which they tell every man to his neighbor, as their fathers have forgotten my name for Baal. The prophet that has a dream, let him tell a dream. And he that has my word, let him speak my word faithfully. What is the chaff to the wheat, says the Lord? Is not my word like as a fire, says the Lord? And like a hammer that breaketh the rock in pieces? Therefore, behold, I am against the prophets, says the Lord, that steal my words, every one from his neighbor. Behold, I am against the prophets, says the Lord, that use their tongues and say, he says. Behold, I am against them that prophesy false dreams, says the Lord, and do tell them it cause my people to error by their lies and by their likeness. Yet I sent them not, nor commanded them. Therefore they shall not profit this people at all, says the Lord. And when this people or the prophet or a priest shall ask thee, saying, what is the burden of the Lord? Thou shalt then say unto them, what burden? I will even forsake you, says the Lord. And as for the prophet and the priest and the people that shall say, the burden of the Lord, I will even punish that man in his house. Thus shall you say every one to his neighbor and every one to his brother, what has the Lord answered? And what has the Lord spoken? And the Lord shall you mention no more, for every man's word shall be his burden. For you have perverted the words of the living God, of the Lord of hosts, our God. Thus shalt thou say to the prophet, what has the Lord answered thee? And what has the Lord spoken? But since you say the burden of the Lord, therefore thus says the Lord, behold, you say this word, the burden of the Lord, and I have sent unto you, saying, you shall not say the burden of the Lord. Therefore, behold, I, even I, will utterly forget you, and will forsake you, and the city that I gave you, and your fathers, and cast you out of my presence. And I will bring an everlasting reproach upon you, and a perpetual shame which shall not be.